Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of the Paint Party Livestream. I am so glad to have you back in the studio this evening. I'm a little wonky tonight, so let me see if I can adjust that. I have had a crazy couple of weeks with my tech problems. My computer completely crashed. I did kind of get it set up, so we're going to do the best we can, but I do have a new one on order, so having to work with some different adapters and things to make it all work. So that said, I am grateful to have you back in the, or to be back every week. I meet you here on Monday night and we work on a painting. Over the last several weeks, I've been working on some of the paintings that are laying around my studio, trying to do some finishing work and some refining to get them cleared up, get them finished, because for a while I was doing, well, over a year, I was doing one new painting every week, and that just ended up that I had piles of half finished paintings. So that's what we're working on. Tonight we're going to continue one that we had started several months ago, and we worked on last week or maybe the week before, because with holidays and things, we have missed some days, but, and I will miss next Wednesday or next Monday, but I'll remind you of that again. But then we should be good, like going into the new year. Yeah, I think that's it. We will jump on. I don't have actually, welcome. Oh, the last thing is you can participate on the live stream. Those of you who've been here before know you can participate wherever you're watching us through the comments on whatever platform you're on. So feel free to do that. And I love engaging with you. So feel free to ask questions or make comments as we go along. That said, I am right before this kicked off, I was running around kind of crazy. And I just realized the adapter that I bought last week, it works for everything except I'm not getting my other webcams to connect, so I'm gonna try that real quick. Otherwise it just may be a little wobbly as I and I apologize for looking off camera. I have, hey there mom and dad, so glad to have you. I suppose dad's probably working upstairs, but mom, good to see you. Yeah, I have a wireless mouse, wireless keyboard, because my computer, basically, my laptop completely died, so I'm using it with an external monitor, and it didn't completely die. The display died, and I have to run everything that I'm running into my computer through one adapter, because I only have one port that works for charging, for everything. So that all these cameras that I have set up. Let me see if I sad because my other one works. I don't know why all the other components are working. That's very strange. And it's both cameras. So I know. Let's see. Let's try one other. Let me try this one and see if it picks up. I don't see it. It could also be my software. I may have to re-recognize these cameras, but that said, it doesn't look like they're going to work for what we need them to work for. So, let's see. Camera A. Well, maybe. Nope. It is camera A is gone. So let's see. Yeah, not sure what is going on, but I will try to get that figured out. That said, pardon me while I try to move you around without making you too sick. Might want to look away from your monitor right now, or your computer or TV. All right, you see all my junky. Now you get kind of the view of what goes on behind the scenes. Okay, and I'm gonna flip you around, so I apologize. Whoops. Usually this is all what's going on. There we are. I think we're better. That is usually what is going on when I am adjusting things, and so now you can see why I say, let me take you to another camera view. So I apologize again for all that drama, but let me put the reference up here. This is what we've been working on. Last week we worked on the clouds, the sky, and I want to continue that, see if we can get it finished up today. So let's see what we can do. I'm going to turn off my keyboard for now so I don't run down the battery. Okay. Let us see here. Ba-ba-ba-ba. We'll be so glad when I get a... I was so excited to get that adapter because I was like, oh, this will work. Then it didn't. So I'll have to see what I can do. See if I can get the camera to be recognized. Okay. Now, the thing that I like that's working really well, I like the contrast of this blue against kind of the clouds here. I think we can tighten up this line to make it even more, you know what I need to do is I need to put up my, because I'm using an external monitor, I need to also pull up my reference photo, because I pulled it up for you, but I didn't pull it up for me. I'm using the same external monitor to run the live stream as well as my reference. So let us see. There we are. Okay, so I think we can do some work there, but I really like that. I like what's happening here. I think we can refine that. And then I do think we can do some work to make this more interesting. But I really want to focus. I really want to kind of finish the sky. I like the contrast of the dark. Now there is a little bit of a glare for you, so it's not exactly what we're looking at, but it's pretty close. So let's see what we can do. Let me get in here and pull some of these brushes out. Maybe, let's see, we need kind of the orange, blue-ish, and what other colors? Maybe purple-ish, and what else? Yeah. I wonder. I have all this paint that I bought years ago that is not, and I apologize, this week you don't see my palette, but I bought all this paint that before I knew how to mix color, and I bought all this paint that was different hues, oranges and things that I don't ever use because I just mix it. So wonder, but I might be able to use some of this orange now. We'll see. I'm just kind of putting a bunch of things out because I'm not sure exactly what I want to do with the sky. I do like the contrast, but I did another painting where there was kind of a, this is kind of a grayish color similar to what's there, but I did another painting that is hanging on my wall here that's kind of a stormy cloud with sky image as well, and it is, I like the purple color that's in there more than the gray, so I want to kind of see what happens if I do some of this. More, because purple and yellow are complementary on the, where's my color wheel? They're opposite, violet and yellow are opposite on the color wheel. So let's see. What we can do. See if we can turn this a little more purple than gray. It may not show up. It's showing up really purple on mine, but on yours, you can see kind of a purple hue. Let's just see what this does. Someday I'll get good at doing clouds. I've said that for years. But when I started, I had no idea what I was doing. It was a mess, those of you who remember. Welcome, welcome, those of you that have come in last few minutes. So glad to have you. All right, there you start to see. This is a much lighter chroma. So we'll, the key with clouds is having, or one of the keys, I think, is having a variety of light and shadows in your clouds so that, because when the sun is shining on clouds, you have, it's reflecting either off the, from the ground up if the sun is setting, and so light and shadow on your clouds is what gives you the shape and three-dimensionality. That's a where it looks. It has volume and it has shape. And so you kind of want to play with that. Now, again, I'm using just a reference, and I'm not really following what I'm seeing now. I'm following what I want to create artistically, the feeling I want on these clouds. And I want a sharp contrast, not a sharp contrast, but I want a subtle contrast of yellow and purple opposite each other, because that's going to, I think, give some really great unity to the painting, because again, yellow and purple are complementary. So and if we can start dialing in some of these shapes, then we can create over time, all of a sudden we'll have something that it already reads very nicely at a distance. I've been looking at this the last couple of weeks, and it's very nice at a distance. So I think doing this can really give us some good shapes to work off of. And like always with acrylic, the more layers we lay in, the better this the more layers we put in, the better it looks, the more oil-like it looks. So I'm using this purple also to just soften some of these edges up above, because it's a little lighter, again, a lighter chroma. So soften the edges of some of these really dark contrast, because we can still get contrast, but we'll get some beautiful, I think, oh, that's turning really, really purple, right? I'm kind of using this lighter tone again to blend in some of these darker areas, because as we get closer to the light, they are more, they should be lighter. Let's see, I just put a little orange color in. Let's see what it does. Kind of that peachy color. Because I see that kind of in the reference. Again, we'll just kind of and we'll get more and more diffused as we go up. Oh, sorry about that. And I think if we do just some real light, put a little blue in to take down the orange. There. this very simple contrast here, putting in just a few brush strokes, will give us shape to some of these clouds. Ooh, that's not good. See if we can. A little bit more red in there. Well, sorry about that. Not sure what's going on. There we are. Now we're back. All right, see what we're doing with the contrast of the dark and the light. All of a sudden, these clouds are popping out. Again, this is not like the... It is pretty different to what the reference photo, but I just like the shape of it. And that's all I'm focused on is, does the shape look good? Does it read correctly? Is it doing what I want to do? Okay, right now, what I'm looking at, I still am not, I don't think I have the right yellows on my palette to do what I want with the clouds. Well, maybe. I have such a sharp, that cad yellow is so aggressive that it quickly overwhelms or can overwhelm. I want to figure out how to, because when I put with white, it gives me the chroma I want, which is the intensity, a very light intensity, but then white also diffuses the uses the intensity of the yellow. The yellow is what I'm going to take a little bit of a different brush now and see. I've seen a couple more people pop in. Welcome. Glad to have you. Thanks for checking out what we're doing tonight. This is where I'm really wanting to I want to be strategic. Because this is going to give us that feeling of brightness, but if I do too much, then there's nothing for it to contrast against. So, and up here is where we get this really intense. Yellow. But in order for the yellow to stand out, we have to keep it, keep the contrast of the darkers. But again, this is what gives us that feeling of volume in these shapes. It's figuring out I wish I could lock it in like as I apply it. Because I apply it and it looks bright and then it dulls down to this. But again, multiple layers. And all of a sudden, it looks very sophisticated and like we've been working, almost like we've been working with oils. And what we need to do now is take in a little bit of this orange, orangey red color. Orange and what's opposite of orange? Blue. So let's diffuse it down a little bit. We'll blend it in. Because what we want, what we need to do, without being too stark, give this yellow something to contrast against, but that isn't like dark, dark. Need to create some shadow, but shadow that is closer to so the yellow is still a highlight, but it's not overwhelming, if that makes sense. So I mixed basically an orange and I added a little blue in it to undercut the orange so it's not like bright neon-ish. Put a little magenta in, a lot of white to diffuse it. Again, blue opposite of orange will, on the color wheel, will diffuse the orange so that we have orange, but it is kind of a shadow orange, if that makes sense. And then up here, we can take that in and it becomes the highlight up here on the top. So it's a shadow down here and it's the highlight up here. Blend it all in so that it's kind of a. Again, we get this really nice hodgepodge of. I like how the sky comes back here. Lighten it. I'm gonna give it a little purple where it just go lighter and lighter. And then it's like, is that sky or is it clouds? That's what we want, kind of this greenish blue to just see how we bring the sky backwards? Now, what I want to do is do that here so that it's clear these are. Carve into some trees again, because the closer we get to the horizon, the more atmosphere we have to look through. So doing this will give us some feeling that we're looking through the horizon. And it gives us a little gradient. You can tell that it's like more blue here and more greenish blue here. And what's awesome about that is we can, again, it gives us contrast with our clouds. And all of a sudden, we can carve out, all of a sudden this stands out. See how that is? So it's really cool. Everyone's so quiet tonight. Just watch me do my thing, I guess. This is probably too bright up there, yeah. Come back and kind of this can give us that highlight, and we can take this back into blue. May not want to take it that bright. We'll see. But I do want to keep lightening this to bring it all the way back to the trees. could almost, not almost, you could overpaint this to death because it's just so fun. And you can just keep adding layers of layers of layers. But eventually then you end up diffusing what you've done because you end up with so much lack of contrast, which again, the key for clouds is, what is it contrasting against? Okay, now I'm coming back and reestablishing some of this landmass. We kind of lost that a little bit. Now, I have this really pretty, oops, I don't know why I do that. This really pretty green. Now we gotta figure out how to do this orange, this yellow, orange, green, pink mixture and white to, I don't know what color this is, but we're just mixing all the colors. Because we need to come back in and do the hay or the fog. I don't know how to make that look correct. So we're just gonna kind of see what it does. That works. It's just kind of hazy. All right, I'm appreciating this more. I do want to get up here and try to work, because I'd really like to get the shape of the clouds a little better, like the whole cloud part. I'd like to get that before the end of tonight, like all of this kind of smoothed out. But I wanted to see what I can do with this. It looks good, like when I look at it on your screen, but up close, I guess it's not supposed to look good up close. Let me step back from it and look. Okay. I don't know what y'all think. It works, but I think you need kind of a the same thing we did up here we need to do down here. But we did. The problem is, again, I'm losing my values a bit, meaning I'm getting too bright too fast. And that's why it's not working. But let's see what we can do to fix that. Very light yellow. This is about the lightest yellow I can go. That's the challenge. There's gotta be this definite like line. So I think I'm gonna go back here, bring in some of this. See if I can. I think it needs to be darker. There. Need a bit more here. Yeah, we need a little darkness. Push those things back into. The distance. Okay, now let's leave this for a minute and come back to this our bluish green. Let's do a little bit lighten it. I think it's too green. A little more blue. Lighten. At one point, I had tried to put orange in here to make it look backlit, and it didn't work. So I'm just kind of taking all of that out. Then we'll reestablish these branches again. All right. There we go. Now, let's go in with really fine brushes and mix as dark as we can. Try to recreate some of this. This is mostly just carving out the skyline again. The most difficult thing about something like trees or plant life is that our human minds want to see always we are defaulting, even when we don't realize it, to non-organic shapes. So we are looking for patterns and we're trying to create patterns. And even when we try to not create patterns, we create patterns. And making a tree look organic is, or can be, a real challenge. Making it look like it grew that way can really can be not easy, especially when you're doing a lot of things at a time like this, where starting to get clumps of paint in my brush, so going to remix my paint, because this was too clumpy. As it dries, it gets paint clumps in it. Nope. Once I rinsed it, there's too much water in the brush. It's crazy. I know this is kind of the boring part, and I'm super quiet. But that is, I think, a necessary part. Now what I'm doing is going back just to establish these kind of structures within the plant, putting very dark kind of through lines so that at a distance, again, we have volume that suggests branches and structure. And again, it gives us, without painting every single little shape or every single little branch, we get some three-dimensional shape. Do that less up here, but a little bit. There. I think that looks relatively organic. What do you think? What do y'all think? What do y'all think? Just doing some random, almost just, you won't see them unless you're right up on the painting, but just some random little polka dot. Leaves that can be they're just kind of distant, very as random as possible. Again, this is very just spots. Okay, I'm gonna stop or I'll overpaint. But it gives the illusion that there's lots of branch movement going on there. Now, I think we have about 20 minutes. So I wanna go back here and kind of see what I can do with these clouds. We started putting this purple color in and I kind of really like it. So I think I want to go back to that. See if we can recreate some of that. We want to dull it down a little bit. So if it's purple, we want to bring in yellow. And it's always going to be darker than it looks. So it's going to look bright here, but it'll dry darker. But hopefully this will give us some shape. So we want very little variance, but we do want to see these shapes of these clouds a little bit. We're going to cover up the sky because I do think I want it all cloudy. We're making it lighter. We'll have to see how this dries. Right now it looks really light, but I'm not sure what it's going to actually look like. I know y'all are getting the glare of this. There you can kind of see what's going on. I take the glare off a little bit, but I don't want to take this little bit of orangish pink. Want to even some of this out a little bit so it's not so oppressive and dark. It back just a little bit. I love this color as long as it doesn't get too dark when it dries. I want to It's the same exact color, just with a little white added to it. So we should be able to come up in here and make some. Ooh, that makes it way too bright. Isn't that crazy? We'll see how it dries though. Oh, that's kind of a mess, isn't it? I think at some point I just have to say that's good enough because it's not what I want. Incidentally, I'm kind of liking how these clouds are shaping up. And I'm almost to the end of my time. Of course, as I'm like, oh, I really like these clouds. Really like what's happening here. Now let's change it up. It's looking very painterly up close, which is what I really want, is so that when you zoom out, it looks like real clouds, but then you get up close and you're like, oh, that's just like a few brush strokes. I'm really liking this. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna say goodnight. And let me turn this off just to see. There, you can see a little bit more what it actually looks like. I do want to put some highlights in there because there's just not a lot of value variance there. Oh, but let me step back and, oh, don't look at my, let's turn that around so you can't see my messy, woo. Again, sorry for not having these cameras all figured out, but there we go. We will try to get it for next time. Again, next week I will be out of town, so no live stream next week either, but then I should be back through the holidays, through the end of the year. Okay, this is what we did. This is kind of what it looks like now. Oh, let me see if I can get rid of the reference photo for you so you can see more. Okay, that's kind of where we are. Not totally pleased with it. I think at some point I'll have to say, I do want to do some work here. I think this shape is off. I think this needs to come down a little bit into here just so it looks like there's like a big cloud or something that's blocking the light. And so that's not what's happening. There should be light out into here. So I want to work on that and see if I can create a similar shape like this almost, pointing, or yeah, like that, pointing the same way the sky points here, this points here, this points here, to our center point. But overall, this one is coming together. I may have to get to the point where I just say, you know what, that's as good as I can do, and that's it. But I do want to, again, thank you for joining me. I hope that you enjoyed the show, and I will see you not next week, but the following week. I think it's the 11th, right here, 6 p.m. Mountain Time. And hope you have a great week, and I'll see you, or 2 weeks, and I'll see you then.